வணக்கம் மை டியர் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், ஐ திங்க் யூ ஆர் ஆல் சேஃப் அட் ஹோம். பி அட் ஹோம், வாஷ் யுவர் ஹேண்ட்ஸ் ரெகுலர்லி. ஓகே, ஸோ பிஃபோர் இட் செல்ஃப் இஸ் கம்ப்ளீட்டட் எக்ஸசைஸ் 1.2 சம்ஸ் யூனோ. நவ் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி எக்ஸசைஸ் 1.3 சம்ஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ எக்ஸசைஸ் 1.3 மிஸ்லேனியஸ் பிராக்டிஸ் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி மேத் த ஃபாலோயிங் அப்ராப்ரியேட்லி. ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன், 5/6 ப்ளஸ் இன்டூ மைனஸ் 1 ப்ளஸ் மைனஸ் 3/4 ஈக்குவல் டு 5/6 ப்ளஸ் மைனஸ் 1 ப்ளஸ் மைனஸ் 3/4. ஸோ அப்சர்வ் திஸ் இயர் ஹாவ் ப்ளஸ் சைன் அண்ட் தே இன்டர்சேஞ்ச் த பிராக்கெட்ஸ் ஒன்லி. ஸோ இன்டர்சேஞ்ச் த பிராக்கெட்ஸ் இன் அடிஷன் மீன்ஸ் டெஃபினெட்லி இஸ் அசோசியேட்டிவ் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி ஆஃப் அடிஷன். ஸோ அசோசியேட்டிவ் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி ஆஃப் அடிஷன் ஃபர் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன், தட் இஸ் த கரெக்ட் ஆன்சர். ஓகே, சி த செகண்ட் ஒன், -1/3 இன்டூ 1/4 ப்ளஸ் 2/3 ஈக்குவல் டு -1/3 இன்டூ 1/4 ப்ளஸ் -1/3 இன்டூ 2/3. ஹியர் திஸ் -1/3 இஸ் கிவிட் டு த டூ ரேஷனல் நம்பர்ஸ் பிட்வீன் திஸ் பிராக்கெட்ஸ் யூனோ. ஸோ வி ஆர் டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட்டிங் தட் -1/3. ஸோ வாட் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி இட் இஸ்? டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட்டிவ் ப்ராப்பர்ட்டி ஆஃப் மல்டிபிளிகேஷன் ஓவர் அடிஷன். திஸ் இஸ் second one. Okay, so see the third one, -4/9 into 9/-4 equal to 9/-4 into -4/9 equal to 1. So here -4/9, the reciprocal of -4/9 is 9/-4. 9/-4 reciprocal is -4/9, we'll get 1. So 1 is a multiplicative identity, no? So this is multiplicative inverse property for this third. Okay, next 1/0. Already I told 1/0 is a not defined value. So here the given does not exist. So 1/4 value is does not exist. This is the fourth one. Okay, next 22/7. What is the remaining then? Rational number. So 22/7 is nothing but a rational number. You can join like this also. So first one is associative property of addition. Second one is distributive property of multiplication over addition. Third one, multiplicative inverse property. Fourth one, the value does not exist. And fifth one is a rational number. Next one, second sum, which of the following properties hold for subtraction of rational numbers y? So here they given some properties. We are going to check whether the subtraction of rational numbers that satisfies that given properties or not. Okay, first one they given closure property. Already we know closure property for addition and multiplication. The collection of rational numbers is closed under addition and multiplication. Okay, now we are going to see whether it satisfies for subtraction or not. The collection of rational numbers is closed under subtraction. We are saying it is closed under subtraction also. For any rational numbers A and B, A minus B is also in rational number, isn't it? So through an example we can get the answer. Let A equal to 3/4, B equal to 1/2. These two are rational numbers is in Q. So you are going to find A minus B, 3/4 minus 1/2. So if you find A minus B, you will get what? 1/4. 1/4 is in rational numbers, you know. So here we taken A and B in rational numbers. We got the subtraction of that two rational numbers are also in rational numbers. So we can conclude that for any rational numbers A and B, A minus B is also in rational number. So we can be able to say that the collection of rational numbers is closed under subtraction. Next we are going to see B1, commutative property. Whether the subtraction of rational numbers satisfies the commutative property or not. So what is the commutative property for addition? A plus B equal to B plus A, you know. For multiplication, A into B equal to B into A. So now we are going to see for subtraction whether it satisfies or not. Commutative property fails for subtraction of two rational numbers. So here they even fails. So how it is failed? We are going to see now. For any two rational numbers A and B, A minus B is not equal to B minus A, no. So check through one example. take A as minus 3 by 4 and B equal to 5 by 4. So let us assume like this. So A minus B. If you find A minus B, I got minus 3 by 4 minus 5 by 4 equal to minus 8 by 4. You will get 4 ones are, 4 twos are. You will get minus 2 here. Okay. So B minus A means B value what? 5 by 4 minus A minus 3 by 4. Here minus into minus will get plus 5 by 4 plus 3 by 4. So 5 by 4 plus the denominators are same. So 5 plus 3 will get 8. 4 ones are 4 twos are. If you cancel now you will get 2. So here you got minus 2. Here you got 2. So minus 2 is not equal to 2. So A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Hence that subtraction of rational numbers does not satisfy the commutative property. Next, see associative property. So we are going to check associative property satisfies for subtraction of rational numbers or not. So what is associative property for addition? A plus B plus C equal to A plus B plus C. So for multiplication also associative property is there, you know. So what is that? A into B into C equal to A into B into C. Now we are going to check the subtraction of rational numbers satisfies the associative property or not. So associative property fails for subtraction of rational numbers. For any three rational numbers A, B and C, A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. So we are going to check with an example. Let A equal to 3 by 5, B equal to 2 by 5, C equal to 1 by 5. So A minus B minus C we are going to find first. So instead of A, you are substituting 3 by 5 minus 2 by 5, C minus 1 by 5. Okay, so 3 minus, here the denominators are same, you know. So subtract the numerator. 3 minus 2 will get 1 by 5. 1 by 5 minus 1 by 5 will get 0. So next A minus B minus C. So 3 by 5 minus 2 by 5 minus 1 by 5. We are going to solve the brackets first. Here the denominators are same. You can subtract the numerator directly. 2 minus 1 you will get 1. 1 by 5. So 3 minus 1 what will you get? 2 by 5. Here you got 0. In this you got 2 by 5. So 0 is not equal to 2 by 5. Hence we write that A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. So hence we proved that associative property does not satisfy the subtraction of rational numbers. Next, D, identity. Identity fails for subtraction of rational numbers. For any rational numbers, A minus 0 is not equal to 0 minus A. For any rational number A, we are taking one rational number as A, A minus 0 is not equal to 0 minus A. So let us assume A value as 4 by 5. So 4 by 5 minus 0, 4 by 5 only, no. What is then 0 minus 4 by 5? You will get minus 4 by 5. So we conclude that A minus 0 is not equal to 0 minus A. So identity fails for subtraction of rational numbers. Next, move on to inverse. Inverse also fails for subtraction of two rational numbers. We have only additive inverse, which doesn't have subtraction. Inverse, okay. So we conclude that inverse also fails for subtraction of two rational numbers. Third one, Subbu spends 1 by 3 of his monthly earnings on rent, 2 by 5 on food, 1 by 10 on monthly usuals. What fractional part of his earnings is left with him for other expenses? Subbu is a person, he spends his monthly earnings 1 by 3 part on rent, 2 by 5 part on food and 1 by 10 part on monthly usuals. Okay, what they asked to find the fractional part of his earnings is left with him for other expenses. So some amount he left with him, you know, that amount fractional part we are going to find. Okay, so Subbu spent his monthly earnings 1 by 3 on rent, 2 by 5 on food and 1 by 10 on monthly usuals. So total spending of Subbu, how much he spends, you are going to find out. So what part they given? 1 by 3 plus 2 by 5
plus 1 by 10. So we have to take LCM. So LCM of 3, 5 and 10 I done here. So you will get 30. So here you have 1 by 3, you know. So you have to multiply with 10 by 10. Here 6 by 6. Here 3 by 3. So 10, 1 into 10, 10, 10 by 30 plus 2, 6 are 12 by 30 plus 1, 3 are 3 by 30. So in, now the denominators become same. So add the numerators. 10 plus 12 plus 3. So 10 plus 12 plus 3 will get 25 divided by the denominator as 30. Here you can cancel with 5 table. 5, 5 are 5, 6 are. So you will get 5 by 6. So how much is spending? Total spending amount is 5 by 6 part of his earnings. So let the total earnings be 1. We are considering the total earnings in the fractional part as 1. So total spending, how much he spent totally? 5 by 6. What they ask, what is the amount left with him? Fractional part of his earnings left with him, they ask, no. So fraction of money left with Subbu. That is total earnings is 1. We are going to subtract what? Total spending 5 by 6. So here 1 by 1 we are going to multiply with 6 by 6. Then only we will get 6 by 6, you know. So 6 by 6 minus 5 by 6. Now the denominators become same. So write 6. So subtract the numerator. 6 minus 5. What is 6 minus 5? 1. 1 by 6. So 1 by 6 part of his earnings is left with him. Okay. Do you understand the sum? Fourth one. In a constituency, 19 by 25 of the voters had voted for candidate A, whereas 7 by 50 had voted for candidate B. Find the rational number of the voters who had voted for the others. So here you have two candidates, that is candidate A and candidate B. So for candidate A, 19 by 20 of the total votes he got. Candidate B, 7 by 50 of the total votes he got. So they asked to find the rational number. Nothing but it is in the form A by B. So we are going to find the fractional part only. So of the voters who had voted for the others. So how many of them voted for the others? You have to find in the form of rational number. Okay. You understand the sum? So next slide. So given voters voted for A. How much? 19 by 25 of the total votes. Of the total votes. Okay. Voters voted for B. So for B candidate, how much voted? 7 by 50 of the total votes. Okay. Then total voters voted for A and B. So total voters means you have to add both 19 by 25 and 7 by 50. So 19 by 25 plus 7 by 50. So the denominators are different. So what is the LCM for 25 and 50? Obviously 50 only, no. So you have to multiply by 2 by 2. So 19 2s are 38, 25 2s are 50 plus 7 by 50. Now the denominators become same. So 50, 38 are the numerators. 38 plus 7. So what is 38 plus 7? You will get 45 divided by 50. You can in 5 table you can cancel, no. So 5 9s are 45, 5 10s are. So you will get 9 by 10. So total votes voted for, total voters voted for A and B is 9 by 10. Okay. So let the total voters be 1. So total voters we are assuming as 1. So what is the remaining voters then? Remaining voters we have to subtract from the total voters minus voted for A and B, you know. So 1 minus 9 by 10. So here you have 1 by 1. So here the denominator is 10. So you have to multiply and divide with 10. So 1 tens are 10. 10 by 10 minus 9 by 10. You got, you know. So now the denominators become same, 10. So 10 minus 9. What is 10 minus 9? 1. So 1 by 10. So 1 by 10 of the total voters are voted for others. Did you understand the sum? What we do in the third sum? The same model only they given here. Okay. Thank you, my dear children. So if you have any doubts, you may ask through our Zoom classes. Thank you so much.